Water lilies comes in a lot of variants, and let's see how to paint water lilies in acrylics today. Let's get started. Hi, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I am Modula, the artist behind Modula Creations, helping you to learn to draw, paint and relax through art. Today let's do a bunch of water lilies. The first thing I would do in this painting is to define the leaves. In the background, the leaves are going to be little bit crazy and abstract. You can leave it like that. And as we move towards the foreground, we are going to keep it clean and neat. So the shapes that you are defining can be very long at the background, and as you come to the foreground, you can have it more rounder and rounder. I'm just using sap green to define all of the leaves. Either it could be the foreground or background or midground. It's only with a sap green I'm defining all the leaves. Water lilies floating leaves are often called lily pads. The water lily leaves are actually circular in shape. So our eye angle is kind of different, right? So we are not seeing it from the top. So you can have it little bit oval to complete circular as well. Water lily leaves also has a notch at the center. So just consider all this and have circular shapes and oval shapes for the lily leaves. We'll start with the flower. For the flower, I'm using a violet along with a white. So just define the tones and the leaves. I'm using a flat brush to do this. It's very easy to create these textures with a flat brush. You can vary the direction of the flower as you want, and you can also have as many flowers as you wish. Keep defining each of the petals separately. And when you wanted to vary the tones, just use purple and a combination of white. If you are just starting out with acrylics and you are confused on color mixing, grab this free PDF from the link guide.modulacreations.com. This is a free ebook for you. Water lilies actually come in a variety of colors. The hardy ones, the hardy varieties of the water lilies, have kind of soft and pastel flowers, and they include yellow, pink, reds, oranges or whites. And the tropical varieties comes in bright blues, purple, bright yellows and oranges. So you have a variety of colors to choose from and paint. And for this, you can actually pick and choose any color of your choice and go ahead to do the water lilies. I have done a similar painting of lotus, a close-up of one flower of lotus. So if you are interested in this, you will be definitely liking that too. So go ahead and watch that. I'll link it in the card above and also in the description box below. I'm now going to darken some of the areas with a violet. So you need not do it everywhere. So wherever you wanted to show the darker colors and the darker tones or the shadows, there alone you can do this. So once you finish the foreground flowers, we can do little bit of midground and background flowers. You need not go into too much of details in these flowers. Just an outline and a depiction of the flower would do. So some can be smaller and some can be larger as well. Once we are done with the flowers, and if you are happy with the placement of those flowers, then we can start on the leaves. So for the leaves, I am using a sap green and pioneer's gray to make it more darker, and little bit of white to make the colors lighter. We are going to just define all the leaves in the foreground and make it little more detailed than the midground and background leaves. You need not have two bright colors like mixing a green with an yellow for these leaves. This has to be little bit subtle so that your flowers just pop out. So in all of the leaves, I'm going to use these colors to make the tonal shifts. You also have the choice to make the leaves however you want to be. You can have some of the leaves folded, or you can have some of the leaves completely open, some little bit underwater, some underneath some of the leaves. So just have a variety of all of this when you are defining the details over the leaves. I do post video tutorials like this one, detailed product reviews and much more on my channel every single week. So do subscribe and also click on the bell icon so that you get notifications from YouTube as soon as I post a new video. Even though each lily may signify different things, on a whole, if you see, lilies usually are the symbol of purity and rebirth. And purple lilies represent power. I am continuing to work on the leaves in the foreground, and I will be defining the edges of each of the leaves completely in the foreground. For today's particular painting, I am using a black canvas. You can actually do it on a white canvas as well. So if you are using a white canvas, go ahead to use a very darker background. Like you can mix sap green and pioneer's gray and use it for your background color. That way the instance of the painting just stays and remains, because water ponds like this have lot of leaves and you just wanted to show how dark it is. And the lilies that we are doing will be almost lighter in color, and it aids in bringing it out. So you can directly do it on a black canvas or use a darker color background to do this painting. You can use the same method to paint the other type of lilies or lotus as well. So the petals will change, you might have to slightly adjust it accordingly. If you got any doubts in any section of this video, do drop it in the comment section. I'll be happy to help you out. The next thing that we are going to do is adding the stalk of the flowers. So since this is a tropical lily that I am going to depict, I am just adding the stalk little bit in a height. Usually the hardy lilies will not have the stalk, they will be directly fixed in the water just above the surface. So just remember on what type of water lily you are painting, and you can adjust your stalks accordingly. The last thing that you can do is to add the center of the flower. So you need not do it for all the flowers, but you can cover most of the foreground flowers. I'm using a lemon yellow and raw sienna to do this center part of the flower. So here is the finished painting. If you like what you saw, just click on the like button. Do share it with your friends who are interested in drawing and painting, and also do subscribe. Let's stay in touch. Here are some useful videos for you to watch. Have a great week and happy painting.